to you by Kenneth Nugent. From the station that's on your side, News 12, First at 5, continues.
A former Evans High School teacher pleads not guilty in a Columbia County courtroom today to charges of sexual conduct by a teacher. Our Will Rio live in our newsroom with the latest developments in this case. Will.
Well, I was in the courtroom with Madison Cooksey today. She's the former Evans High School student who is accusing Scott Hooker of touching her inappropriately. She was able to see Scott Hooker on a screen for the first time in a long time, which was emotional for her. Now, here's a breakdown of what happened in court today. Scott Hooker will face a jury trial for charges stemming from incidents that happened in 2017 in Columbia County. He remained in Columbia County Jail this morning ahead of his hearing over an incident with former student Madison Cooksey, like we were saying. She's accusing him of inappropriately touching her on Valentine's Day back in 2017 at Evans High School. After that incident, Hooker moved on to Burke County, where he would later be arrested and charged over similar allegations as Madison Cooksey's. Now, we found that there is a process and requirement for certified teachers in our local school districts to notify the Georgia Professional Standards Commission if their code of ethics was broken. We found that no one in the Columbia County School District had reported Scott Hooker. We break that down coming up on News 12 at 6 o'clock.
Will Rio in our newsroom for us. Will, thank you. A babysitter facing charges after a 3-year-old is found wandering the streets today in Martinez. Columbia County deputies say the toddler was found in the area of Palmetto Drive, and deputies eventually found the child's home over on Deerwood Court. The child's babysitter, Stephanie Jones, 37, of Martinez, was in bed sleeping, not aware the child was out of the house. Child welfare workers turned the child over to a family friend since their mother is working right now in Michigan. Jones was arrested and charged with deprivation of a minor. Have you seen this man? 72-year-old Eddie Ruffin, last seen 10 days ago on Mike Paget Highway near Castle Pines Mobile Home Park. Ruffin may have dementia and has trouble walking without his walker, which he left behind at a residence. He's known to frequent the Food Line on Mike Paget Highway, so if you've seen him, call the number there on your screen, 706-821-1048. Much more news ahead. Let's get a Senate for debates. An Aiken man in jail this afternoon accused of sexual incidents with four minors. The police report says the incidents happened between August 20th and September the 2nd. 33-year-old Charleston Duran Horton was arrested Saturday after a father reported to authorities his daughter told him she and her siblings were being sexually assaulted by Horton, who is known by one of the parents. Horton facing 8 counts for those allegations. We now know the identity of the second person found dead at USC in Columbia. 20-year-old Stephen Black of Greenville was found last Friday after around 8:30 in the morning. Black is the second person found dead on campus. The coroner previously identified 48-year-old Anna Glicka Shrews of Columbia. The coroner's office has not released the cause of death, but says they're working with SLED and campus police on this investigation. SLED officials say the deaths happened at separate locations, and they appear to be unrelated. A celebration of life event announced for former Augusta University President Dr. Bill Bloodworth. It'll happen next Monday at the Maxwell Theater on the Somerville campus. That event starts at 11 in the morning. And in lieu of flowers, donations can be made to support the William A. Bloodworth Jr. Endowment. Donations can be mailed to the Augusta University Foundation as well. Today, Dr. Brandon Traxler with DHEC gave updates on both COVID and monkeypox as vaccines and cases continue to trend up for both. A new COVID vaccine that targets the BA4 and BA5 subvariant will be available soon. People 12 and up will be able to get the Pfizer shot. People 18 and up will be able to get the Moderna. Dr. Traxler says you should wait 2 months after your last dose or 3 months after you've had COVID before you get the vaccine, and they should be available statewide by the end of the week. For more information on how to schedule your vaccine appointment, head to our website, WRDW.com. Health officials are bracing for a spike in COVID cases this fall, and those numbers could spike as soon as this week. Kennedy Harris spoke with an infectious disease expert to find out what we can expect this fall.
For years, it's been the same virus, new variants. And Dr. Helmut Albright with Prisma Health says that hasn't changed.
Just nobody talks about it anymore. And really nobody tracks it anymore.
Because of the trend and the availability of take-home tests, he says the number of COVID cases is severely underestimated. But hospitalizations show a trend.
We've had an increase in admissions and deaths in the hospital.
It's nowhere near as bad as it was a year ago, and it won't overwhelm hospitals anymore, but
even 50 cases a day in the hospital with COVID is a lot more than the 5 cases that we were earlier in the year.
And he says it could spike more. The predominant variant floating around right now is still highly contagious, but mostly mild. Experts are also keeping an eye on the next one.
No guarantee that it will stay that way. The next variant may be significantly more virulent.
The new round of boosters approved last week protects against the current variant and possibly against the next one. Dr. Albright says if you haven't gotten COVID in the last 2 months, a booster in the last 6 months, plan to travel, or have a high-risk condition, it might be a good time to get another poke.
But if you opt for a booster, I think this new booster is potentially better.
Dr. Albright recommends speaking with your healthcare provider to decide if and how soon you might need that booster. He says if not enough people get this next round, it could give the virus more room to mutate and evolve. Congressman Rick Allen will be making a stop here at the Bon Air Apartments in Augusta tomorrow. You know, a month ago, we told you the complex failed their last inspection. That was after Representative Allen called for the Federal Housing Authority to launch a formal investigation into the living conditions at the complex back in April. We'll let you know what comes out of Congressman's visit tomorrow at the Bon Air. Augusta Commissioners approving the zoning request for the Regency Mall renovation dubbed the Cardinal Town Square. Commissioners say by this time next year, we can expect ground to be broken for this development. The abandoned mall will be a new home for apartment units, a performing arts center, and more businesses. We'll keep posted on the progress there. The Augusta Regional Airport looking for local artists and musicians. Some artwork they're looking for includes 2 and 3D pieces for display inside the terminal. Musicians would be needed to perform during Christmas this year and Masters Week next year. All applicants have to apply by September 23rd, and we have that link to do that on our website. Columbia County Parks and Rec hiring some part-time athletic assistants for the fall season. It is a flexible job opportunity for the evenings. If you're interested, send an email to the address right there on the screen. That's jenenglish@columbiacountyga.gov. Well, still to come, a world powerlifting champion with dozens of titles to his name. Now he's wearing a new one with pride. We talk to him in just a moment.
And we are enjoying a beautiful afternoon across the CSRA. A lot of sunshine out there for us. More wet weather heading our way though late in the forecast. Update just after the break.
He's known as the world's strongest granddaddy. A 27-time world powerlifting champion lives right here in Hepzibah. We'll get caught up with him as he prepares for another championship run.
I'm Pete Knight, the world's strongest granddaddy. 66 years old, 95 pounds, drug-free. And very good looking.
T. Skinny Man Myers might be 66 years old, but he doesn't let his age stop him.
Even with an old car, you're gonna keep patching it up. Cause if I can't get a new body, so I gotta what? Take care of what I got. So I'm still going.
And he's still winning. Over the last 4 decades, he set more than 50 world records and won 27 world titles.
I got my world titles at Ric Flair. How about that? Now, woo!
The question is, does he have more titles or nicknames?
The world's strongest granddaddy, King Daddy Supreme, Hershey Hammer, every muscle like Cocoa Cruncher, Brown Bruce, Electric Milkshake. Woo!
But Skinny Man is what many know him as. That's what he was before he became a champion.
I was in the military. I barely made the military because I had to lift 70 pounds and I was struggling to lift that 70.
Through hard work, he bulked up into a champion who continues to prove the doubters wrong.
The first thing they tell me is that you're too old to be doing this. Did you just see me do it?
And as he showed in our interview, that competitive fire still burns.
If you get me excited, you better leave me alone. You want some?
Turning down his challenge, Will Bulk.
Let me calm down. My blood pressure going up. I'm sorry.
On your side.
Well, you better keep your distance. He knows what he's doing, and he's got the muscle now. Meyer says he will compete in the USA Drug-Free Championships this weekend in Atlanta. If he wins there, he's going to compete for his 28th world title. We wish him the best. We'll let you know how he does. And here's First Alert Chief Meteorologist Riley Hale. Riley, an inspiration for all of us, no matter the age.
Absolutely.
If you got too old, you just saw him do it, right?
Exactly right. Age is just a number to him, and that is the best mindset to have. And hope he does well in the competition this week.
to Clemson, fell to fifth.
Melissa, thanks. If you're all alone, you need emergency help, you can use your smartphone to call 911. But what if you don't have time to dial that after the break? It's an iPhone feature everyone should know about. If you're ever in a scary situation, your smartphone can be the difference between life and death. Dialing 911 takes just a few seconds, but what if you don't have time to take out the device, open the phone app, dial the numbers, or maybe you just don't want someone knowing you're calling for help? Our consumer tech reporter Jamie Tucker shows us an SOS feature on every smartphone that may save a life.
And this is an emergency feature that a lot of people don't know about, and even those that do never set it up. But it will call 911 for you, alert your family and friends that you need help, and it will lead them or police right to you. It's called Emergency SOS. On an iPhone, quickly press the side button 5 times or simultaneously hold down the side button and a volume button for 5 seconds. When the timer hits 3, the bird sounds an alarm that just might scare away someone threatening you. When the timer hits 0, the phone dials the nearest 911 call center. It'll also notify everyone in your emergency contacts that you called for help. In settings, select Emergency SOS. Make sure this toggle, Call with 5 presses, is turned on. And add emergency contacts to your list. They'll receive your location on a map, which will be updated if you change locations. The alarm sound can be turned off in settings if you'd rather have that option to call 911 without alerting anyone around you. Emergency SOS also works on the Apple Watch by holding down the bottom side button for a few seconds. You will need to be able to swipe this slider to the right. On an Android phone, you'll find Safety and Emergency under Settings. If not, look for it under Advanced Features. Press the power key 3 times quickly to contact 911 and message your emergency contacts. Set up your emergency contacts on an Android phone in Safety Settings. And this is a feature everyone should have set up on their phone. Remember, you can test this to see if it works, but if you do, make sure you hit cancel because it will call 911. That's What the Tech. I'm Jamie Tucker.
Great information to remember right there. That Emergency SOS feature has been credited for saving the lives of victims of carjackings, kidnappings, and domestic assaults. So certainly a good one to keep in mind.
Looking ahead to the weekend forecast, if you do have outdoor plans, we are anticipating widespread rain chances Saturday and Sunday, so you may want to have some of those plans inside. Now look at the 7-day forecast just after the break. Stay and then better storm chances for the rest of the week.
Riley, thanks very much. That's going to wrap things up for News 12, first at 5. News 12 at 6 o'clock starts after the break, but Laura Warren joins me for that.